Hello friends, today we'll be discussing in this video the fields of applied psychology. You very well know that the psychology is a vast subject which is defining the new paradigms of human behavior and other fields. So this psychology is not limited to certain fields. There are various fields where psychological principles and theories are being applied on daily basis by various researchers and experimenters and scientists and of course psychologists. So the purpose, the objective of this video is to let us discuss what are the fields which are very very important and where psychology has proved its worth. In this video, the main focus will be on the major fields of applied psychology. The fields which are going to discuss are not exhaustive. They are not limited to that only. But my focus is only this in context of BA final, that is sixth semester of undergrad students. So friends, now let us start fields of applied psychology. See, you can see gushing sound of water at background of me. I am recording this video at IIT Mandi, which is located at Kamand in the Himachal Pradesh. So now let us start. From the day Wilhelm Wundt established first psychology laboratory in 1879 to date, psychology has come a long way. It started with functionalism, psychoanalysis, structuralism. These are various schools of psychology, behaviorism, humanism, and established various psychotherapies and various techniques. The psychology entered almost every aspect of human life. You can take it other way that every aspect of human life is being studied in the perspective of psychology. Earlier also, there was a psychology in every field, but nowadays, the focus has been shifted to scientifically study this. So during this journey, various theories, principles and laws of psychology came into being and which are being applied in various fields, such as health, clinical aspect, you can say, education, sports, politics, economics, industry and organization, counseling, forensic, etc., with results, encouraging results and wonderful results. So these fields and these areas improved, enhanced the scope of applied psychology. Now we're going to discuss various fields which are major fields of applied psychology. These are, I already told you that, not all. Apart from that, various fields that exist where psychology plays its important role. So let us start one by one. First and foremost is cognitive psychology. What cognitive psychology is? It investigates mental processes involved in acquisition, storage, manipulation and transformation of information received from the environment. That environment can be internal as well as external, along with usage and communication. The major cognitive processes are attention, perception, memory, reasoning, problem solving, decision making, language acquisition, speech, etc., etc. These processes come under the purview of cognitive psychology. The next we quote is biological psychology. It focuses on the relationship between behavior and the physical system of the human body. What the physical system is? The brain and the rest of the nervous system, the immune system and genetics. These are the one who study these concept, biological concept in context of psychological principles. That field becomes as a biological psychology. Biological psychologists often, they collaborate for research for new findings with whom? With neuroscientists, geologists, anthropologists and other individuals working in the similar field. So let us shift to the next. Neuropsychology, it's a very very important and it is developing so fast. It studies, what is the role of neuropsychology? It studies the role of neurotransmitters, certain chemicals, substances which are in our brain, which the neurons release while communicating with each other, are responsible for neural communication. That is in different area of the brain and therefore in associated mental functions. So neuropsychology, in association with neuroscience, are studying and they are developing artificial intelligence and other deep learning and mental processes, that is, you could say the machine learning, in a collaboration with computer scientists, neuroscientists and other individuals working in the field. So the next is cross-cultural and cultural psychology. What is its role? It examines the role of culture in understanding behavior, thought and emotion. See, these are the three aspects. Know the three other aspects also? I have just mentioned here three. So what is the role of culture? How individual behavior or thought pattern or emotions vary with varying the cultural background. It assumes that human behavior is not only a reflection of human biological potential, but also a product of culture. The cross-cultural psychology believes that human is a wonderful product of its cultural values and cultural aspects, not only human biological. Next is environmental psychology. Dear friends, it is a very, very important science. We must, the students who are studying the psychology and researchers who are engaging in working with psychology, they must focus on environment, because due to this climate change, global warming has occurred, and I can say that human being is the only responsible for this process. Only means almost responsible for this process. There may be some other natural hazards which are beyond our limits, but we can control and we can, it is an irreversible process, and we can not only control that, we have to minimize our luxurious life so that we can save our environment for our future. What this environment psychology studies is the interaction of physical factors such as temperature, humidity, pollution and natural disasters, human behavior. I want to say that environmental factors, how they influence and affect the human behavior, when we study these, how they interact with each other, when we study this, this comes under the purview of environmental psychology. Along with this, environmental psychology also tries to understand the influence of physical arrangement of the workplace where we are working. What is the environment of that working workplace on health, emotional state and interpersonal relations? These are also investigated by the environmental psychology. The next is developmental psychology. This field studies the physical, social and psychological changes occurring in different age patterns along the continuum of the age, and what are the state, what are the stages of that age, from conception to old age. The moment we conceive, from that process on to the moment we dissolve in the oblivion, there is a long process along this timeline. What are the developmental changes? These development changes, how our affects our psychological traits and characteristics? That is the purview of study of developmental psychology. Dear friends, it also, they try to know, those people who are working in the developmental psychology, they are known as developmental psychologists. They try to find out, they try to explore how we become what we are. The next is social psychology. This area detects how people are affected by their social environment. Means, here affected means behavioral changes. How that behavioral change occurs in context of social environment. How people think when they are in a social, when they are in a group, when they are under the influence of some crowd, or they are within the, survived by some different peoples of their own society, how they think, how and their thinking or their behavior, how affect others. These are the fields, these are the areas where social psychology come into being and social psychologists study. Social psychologists are interested in which topics? They are interested in attitudes of people towards other people, conformity, obedience, mutual attraction, bias, aggression, social inspiration, intergroup relations, etc., etc., etc. In these fields, social psychologists try to know why we behave as we behave. So let us go over the next. Next is health psychology. It focuses on the role of psychological factors. For example, stress, anxiety, depression, in the development, prevention and treatment of illness. Here illness is the physical illness. In the physical illness, when people is physically ill, to make that people individual physically ill, how the psychological principles, psychological processes such as stress and anxiety influence that physical illness. The next we call it as a clinical and counseling psychology. It deals with causes, treatment and prevention of different type of psychological disorders such as anxiety, depression, eating disorders and chronic substance abuse. Dear friends, clinical psychology is purely deals with diagnosis and offering treatment to people who are suffering from psychological disorders, mental disorders. And a related area to clinical is, it is a complementary area, you call it as a related area is counseling. Which, what the counseling do is, it aims to improve everyday functioning by helping people solve their daily problems and cope more effectively with challenging situations. And counseling psychology is a type of talking cure where it helps the individual to improve their lifestyle, to improve their quality of life through discussions, through modifications of human behavior. So, dear friends, now let us go for the next. Industrial and organization psychology, already we have studied that people start using their psychological principles in organizational setups. Industrial Revolution brought this concept inside the industrial workforce. What it is? It deals with workplace behavior. How individuals behave when they are in the professional setup, focusing on both the workers and the organizations that employ them. This means that psychology try to study how workers behave while they are in the professional setup, where on the other hand, how the managers or organizations try to treat them. So these are the two fields, interaction of these two fields, mainly the organization psychology studies. Along with that, industrial or organization psychologists are concerned with training the human resources, those who are coming to that organization, improving work conditions so that the productivity can be improved, and developing criteria for selecting employees for particular jobs, specific jobs, so that their temperament can match with the organizational setup. Next is very important, educational psychology. It is name itself suggests that it studies how people of all ages learn. That learning process is not a static process, it is a dynamic. Individual through this continuum of life, lifespan learns, and how that individual learns, that is the major area of educational psychology. People who work through the educational psychology, they are known as educational psychologists. They primarily help develop instructional methods and materials used to train people in both educational as well as work settings. They are also concerned with research on issues of relevance for education, why education is required, and what are the implications of education, and what is the best techniques that can, through that, education can be imparted. That counseling and learning process, they are helping parents deal with the various issues that are related to the education, and etc. These are the areas where educational psychology come into being, and educational psychologists help the society. The next is sports psychology. It applies psychological principles to improve sport performance by enhancing their motivation. Why? I'll explain it with an example. Sports psychology is a relatively new field, but is gaining acceptance worldwide, and people are understanding how the psychological principles can improve this sports performance despite people are having their similar physical strength, almost similar. The example of Milkha Singh in 1960 Royal Olympics, Milkha Singh was running ahead of all the participants, while before he just looked back, he was about to finish the line with a top slot, but unfortunately he looked back for a fraction of a second, and within that second the three individuals bypassed him, crossed him, and he became the fourth. At that position, they were all equal as far as physical strength is concerned. He was lacking psychological counseling and psychological mental toughness. If he would have been told that you can achieve, whereas there is my psychological setup would have been programmed in such a way, or you can say modified in such a way, that he would have to worry about the people who are coming behind him, he would have been top position. So this is a fine example. Other examples are, there is competition anxiety. The sportsman and sportsperson feel at a certain level of anxiety, they wish to visit loo several times before they enter in the competition. These issues are dealt with sports psychologists, and it is a wonderful field, and it is improving the performance of sports person without any intervention, extensive interventions or medication. That is the beauty of sports psychology. And last, we'll see other emerging branches of psychology, or you call the field of psychology. The interdisciplinary focus of research and application of psychology has led to the emergence of varied areas like aviation psychology, space psychology, military psychology, forensic, rural, engineering, managerial, community, and psychology of women, and finally, political psychology, to name a few. Dear friends, this list was not, again I'm telling, not exhaustive. Other fields are available where psychology is entering and people are understanding its relevance. So dear friends, it was our today's lecture. That is, next lecture we are going to discuss will be careers in psychology. Those students who have taken psychology as their study field, how they can improve themselves and what are the career options available. So dear friends, thanks for watching this video. Any doubt or any comment, you can email me at vermasujit@yahoo.com. I will be happy to reply to your emails. Thank you. See you next time.